happiness, more or less. It's just a change in me, something in my liberty. On my mind. Happiness coming and going. I watch you look at me, watch my fever growing. I know just where I am. But how many corners do I have to turn? How many times do I have to learn? All the love I have is in my mind. But I'm a lucky man with fire in my hands. Happiness, something in my own place. I'm steady naked, smiling, I feel no disgrace. Happiness coming and going. I watch you look at me, watch my feet are growing. I know just who I am. And how many corners do I have to turn? How many times do I have to run? All the love I have is in my mind. I hope you understand.
Still in search of critical sharpness now. So now I'm back to the Celestron LX, Ultimate LX 13mm. Take a look at the eye of the Lord Islay. And you'll see, let me just see, can I see it on this phone screen? So on this phone screen, it doesn't show up, but just looking through the eyepiece with my own eye, you can see his eye is made of concentric rings. You can actually see the concentric rings of his eye. But that's where the camera phone is letting it down a little bit. I guess it's compressing the image. So you cannot see that detail, but you can see it in this eyepiece without the phone. So I'll just get the zoom again and see if it can match it. Yeah, so I'm back to the Celestron zoom, the 18-24, and I've got it zoomed to about 13mm to match the other eyepiece. And yeah, so even looking through it without the phone, I cannot see those rings in the Lord Islay's eye, the concentric circles that make up his eye, that I can see in the other one. So there's a little bit of a difference there, right? I'm going to just zoom back and take you up to what I'm talking about. So here's the scope. We're about 25 feet away. So let's just walk up to the Lord Islay. There we are. And let's see if we can see it now, right up close. The phone will focus here. Just touch it on the screen. I think it's a little too close for the phone to focus. Let's try zoom a little bit and stand back. There, now you can see it. You see the concentric rings? I could see that clearly through the 13mm eyepiece, but I couldn't see it through the zoom. And you can see it there. It's quite a piece of resolution for the eyepiece and the scope to show that from that distance away. Here's my finger coming into the frame for perspective. Now I'm actually touching it, right? So you can see it's a fraction the size of my fingernail. And the scope is back down there. All right, that's it for now. All right, we're looking through the 13mm Celestron once again. I just remember there's one more test we have to do. And that is we have to try the stop down cap to see do we lose any resolution. So again, visually I can see these concentric circles in the eye of the Lord Islay. Oh, I think I can just see it in this phone now. And now I'm going to put the cap on. So let me just pause there. I'll actually show you what we're going to do here. So I'm going to put this. So we're looking at 120, we're having 4.7 inch of aperture right now. And we're going to put the stop down cap on, which will take us down to 50mm. So you'd imagine by everything that we've seen and read online that, well, that's going to be a terrible view, right? So let's just see. We'll probably lose some brightness, I think. I'm guessing we won't lose any noticeable resolution. That's what I'm guessing. Let's see if I'm wrong. I can still, now I actually can, now that I've learned to see it on this phone, I can still see the resolution. I can still see the circles, the concentric circles in the eye of the Lord Islay that I couldn't see in the zoom eyepiece. So even that 50mm stop down, it's still there. It still shows you that fine a detail, right? Pretty amazing. All right, I just wanted to know that for myself. There you go. Bye for now. I
I watch you look up and watch my fever growing alone.